Hello and welcome. Today, we're going to be working on restoring this True Temper Kelly Perfect Double Bit Axe. Let's get to it. So I picked this axe up for a reasonable sum at a yard sale today, and the reason why I was interested in this axe specifically is because a couple of years ago, I ran across this True Temper Kelly Perfect Single Bit Jersey Pattern Axe. It was buried in the dirt, and I saw the shards of the handle sticking out. I had to do a lot of work on this one, a lot of welding, actually, to get the eye built back up, and now it's a beautiful piece. So when I saw this one, I saw potential. So in order to transform this axe to look like this one, we're gonna need a variety of tools. I've got my grinders with some flap discs from 40 all the way up to 120, random orbital with discs all the way up to 220, and a wire wheel. I'm gonna clean up the bit first, clean up the handle, and get it looking like new. Let's get to it. So here you can see the difference between the side we hit with the random orbital and the side that was hit with just the flat disc. We got a much smoother, more uniform surface. Logo cleaned up pretty nice. We can see we have just about all of it there. Missing a little bit on that K, but all in all, cleaned up pretty nice. We're just gonna keep going now. Now we've gotten everything cleaned up and sharpened up and haven't polished it yet, but we'll get there in a minute. I'm gonna sand down this handle and get it smoothed out first before we do our final polish. But already you can see working through from 120 and then all the way up to 600 and 800, we've really made a difference. And these bevels are just mirrors now, looking really, really pretty. So here we've got everything pretty good and cleaned up. We're now ready for our final polish. Basically just gonna polish up these edges and the whole head overall and give it a nice uniform look. Yeah, I think that's sharp. Wow. Now at this point, I'm just gonna wipe off any excess buffing compound with some WD-40. Getting all these nooks and crannies. So there you have it. That's pretty much all there is to it. I'm really happy with how this turned out. I might buff and sand this a little more, but for all intents and purposes, this is beautiful. And we now match our jersey pattern. So any questions, comments, or concerns can be left in the comments section down below. Check us out, Iron Wolf Industrial, on Facebook. and Instagram. Subscribe here on YouTube if you're not subscribed already. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Work hard and stay humble.